shadow, swamp, gloom, and vine. A fog does rise to cloud my mind, to hide the prize I seek to find. Oh, ancient orb, where rest you now?
My lady, I have answered your summons. I am prepared to...
Yes, I see it. A place of traps to crack brave bones. There lies the orb, far, far away. An ancient dungeon, and within it lies the orb.
It's a strong magic that can point to maps. Now, what will you be paying me to fetch the orb?
There lies gold and gem enough for any man. Take what you will, but return the orb to me.
You'll pay me now, or I'll never get there. I need horses, supplies...
Enough! Let the journey begin!
Hey, no, wait! No way!
Live or die, adventurer, but bring the orb to me.
Odd blood! My insides feel all twisted about. Shall we see what awaits?
Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Hack. I say welcome back because those of you that have been with me since I started LPing will know that I have actually played this before. This was my first LP, and I don't have it on my channel because looking back at it, it is terrible. It is bad. You could tell that I was just picking up how to do things. Had all kinds of video and audio trouble and all that good shit. Anyways, I'm going to tackle it again, and we're going to actually finish it this time. I'm not going to be quite as hardcore with it as I was the first time. We're going to do a shorter dungeon just so I can get done with it. I'm also going to probably link my original LP, or at least a playlist of it, in the description box for this so you guys can go back and see where I started and how bad it was. Things are a bit different now, thankfully. We're going to create our own character. You can actually choose your own character. They have a large number of preset characters that you can pick from, as you can see. This runs off of 2nd edition Dungeons & Dragons rules, I believe. We are going to be playing the character that started it all. We are going to be playing Devon. And we are going to be a fighter cleric mage, which more or less means that we need good stats across the board, except in charisma. And we're going to be a half elf, we're going to be a male, chaotic good. There we go. Alright, now with stat generation, more or less, I'm not going to increase them because if I wanted I could have all 18s. But what I will do is, like, say I roll and I want, like, the 17 from constitution and my wisdom, I will just move it over there and switch the scores around. Which this is actually a pretty damn good starting set here. Let's see. That low wisdom hurts on my cleric end, but the cleric and 9 hit points. That's a killer. Yeah, we're not gonna go with that. We want a good chunk of hit points, because otherwise we're gonna end up getting pasted in like the first level here. Ooh, 2 18s, damn. Basically, this is, since this is 2nd edition, it's a bit different from newer editions of D&D. The big thing that most people notice with stat generation is, if I can do it here, I'll just show you guys. Fighters, when you have an 18 strength, you also get a percentile because they're just better than everybody else at fighting. Armor class works inversely. Lower is better. Hit points are hit points. Levels are separate. In 1st and 2nd edition multiclassing, you actually had to keep track of multiple experience point totals, and your classes would just kind of level on their own. Now, as a fighter, cleric, mage, we're going to level really damn slow. So I think we might play a bard. Just because they're pretty much jacks of all trades, they're very, very powerful. I've beaten this multiple times with a bard. Actually, the first time I beat it as a bard was a dare from my younger brother, because bards suck, ha ha ha. Which really isn't the case. They're actually very, very powerful in 1st and 2nd edition, so we're going to do that. Bard fits Devon. See, I think we need a high intelligence, though. Let's see, do that. Oh, we need a good charisma, too. Damn. 14 hit points. We'll go with this. This looks pretty good. Okay, and where's the Devon face? There's the Devon face. Devon is a swarthy man. Okay, gotta move my keyboard here. Move with the number pad. Alright, and we're gonna go custom. Okay, we're going to go... Let's see, the cap is 25, we'll go 15. Oh, that's midway. 18, seems fair. We'll go with a middling amount of monsters. Lots of treasure, lots of food. That's okay. No pits. Pits are pains in the ass. No hints either, because we're badass. We won't go with a water level or multi-level puzzles. We will encounter undead, and there will be magical zones. Monster difficulty will throw middling high. Magic power will keep middling. Poison strength, middle low. And we will throw on enemy spells, and that looks about good. Okay, now this is going to be on a random upload schedule, so yeah, I'm probably going to play for about half hour, give or take, every episode. I'm probably going to aim for an hour. And this game has no music. In my original LP, I actually pasted music into it, but I'm not going to this time because I'm not feeling like doing it. Alright, now let's see what spells we've got here. We have Burning Hands and Magic Missile and... Ooh, Identify, that's good. Alright, we're going to drop Magic Missile for another Burning Hands and we're going to rest. Now, I believe Bards can cast... Alright. So we've got to get rid of our armor at some point. And we have a bow and some arrows, which I'm probably not going to use. But we've got it anyways. And we have our first monster. It looks like an orc. And the game does track what you've killed, which is really cool. You also have a Hall of Fame, which shows people who have been pasted or actually beaten the game before you. Now, I think the level cap in this is 20 for most characters. Multi-class characters won't get to 20 because of the experience caps and that the game just isn't that long. Oh man, Devon just pimp-slapped that orc to death. Because he's hardcore. And we have a topaz and a key of faith. These are both keys. As a rule, you don't find treasure in this game. You can find coins, but those are used to see what... Or they're not used to see what stuff is. They're used to activate these little healing altars that are fairly useful if you're not playing a character that can cast heal. Okay, we have a dogwood wand, and this is one of the coins. That's like a middling heal. The gold ones heal you full health. Protection from petrification we're going to hold on to. There are monsters that will petrify you in this, and it is an instant kill. So we're going to identify this wand and see what we've got here. Now, take off our armor. We have a wand of fire, which I think shoots like fireballs. So we will hold on to that. That is useful. And you can kind of dance with monsters in this like an Anvil of Dawn. It's not quite as effective, but it works. As you can see, things still hit me. And I should actually probably pull back and save so I don't have to create my character again. There. Alright, let's find out what this wand does. Bitch is gonna get fireballed. Yeah. See, now the thing is that with bars, they start out... Damn it. They start out very, very weak. a pink potion. Devon has an armor class of 8. That is very, very, very terrible. That is like the equivalent of having an armor class of 12 in 3rd edition D&D. It is bad. Things will not miss him very often. We're going to sleep to heal. Yes. Now, since we don't have any healing magic, we're going to have to be sleeping a lot, which, as you can see, uses a lot of food. I believe bards eventually get the create food spell, but I may be wrong on that, and if I am, God help me. Alright. I don't really want to be wasting all of the charges from my wand here. And those are hobgoblins. They are obnoxious. Protection from cold. I don't want your damn protection spells. Give me, like, shield or something. And this is one of the things where you can put coins into it and heal yourself. I think the gold coins actually fully fill your food as well. Get out of here, you stupid sucker. We really need to find better armor, or like a robe of protection or a ring of protection. Because once we get to the second or third level, we're going to start getting killed. Like, things will be able to one-shot us. And we have a magic amulet. I'm going to assume it's magical, because I don't know of any non-magical amulets in the game. Now, Fireball is an AoE. If there are multiple creatures standing in the same square, it will hit them all. That's actually why I picked Burning Hands as opposed to Magic Missile for Devon as well. Because Burning Hands is an AoE. It hits the front row. Potion of Invisibility and a... ooh, Potion of Confusion. We do not want that. That is cursed. This game does take some liberties from roguelikes. The dungeons are random every time you come in, and they do kind of like to fuck you. There are cursed items. A lot of cursed items. Weapons are the worst, especially at this point, because to identify them, you have to equip them, and if they're cursed, you're stuck with them. At least until you pick up, like, the remove curse spell. And you can actually examine tapestries. It appears to be dedicated to the element of air. You can examine more or less anything on walls. A pair of bracers. Some more food and a bow that is mine that I'm never going to use because there's really only one ranged weapon in this game that's worth anything, and that's the spiritual hammer spell because it comes back. And we have a grappling hook. These are used to descend pits. However, since we have pits off, it is completely useless to us. We have, ooh, another wand of fire. Sweet. Now, as a bard, Devon is able to use, I believe, items from both classes, so like if I find a wand of healing, I will be able to use that as well, which is very, very helpful later in. I can also use scrolls from both classes. I don't know if I can cast spells from both classes, but I can use scrolls from them. God dang it. Amulet of Imminent Return. These take you back to the entry of a level, and bracers of... oh my god. They're really foisting the archery on me, so I might as well use it. The reason I hate bows so much in these games is because you have to pick up the damn ammo, and it's a pain in the ass. I have the same problem with the Eye of the Beholder games. It is obnoxious and time-consuming. Especially when you've got people that'll be carrying like 20 or 30 arrows. Whoa! Typically you won't go through them all in a fight, but it's still kind of a pain that you can't like just left-click on them and it automatically quivers them for you. There's... oh, you sneaky bastard. Oh, just die already. There we go. Now, bards in 2nd edition, they were kinda good at everything, but not... they were jacks of all trades, masters of none, like, to a T. They fought pretty well, they could cast spells okay, they could fight in, like, frontline combat if they had to. But as a rule, you'd want friends along with you if you were running through something as a bard. However, in single-player games like this, they're actually fairly good if you're careful, but you can die. Let's see here. Okay, what do we got? Some pipes. Now, these could be one of a couple things. They could be pipes of, like, door opening, or they could be pipes that cause us to become starved. However, I think it's actually chimes that make you starve in this. Let's see, do I have anything else that I need identified? Not really. Okay, let's find out what these things are. Pipes of Fane Imagery. Ah, okay, so detect magic. That actually is pretty useful. The reason being, you can find weapons and stuff in this, and while a lot of stuff is magical, ooh, magic ring, not everything is magical, and I don't want to be wasting improved identify spells on things that aren't magic, at least not yet, because food is a limited thing for me right now. Make your move. Die. Okay. Holy shit. There are a number of things in there, and I thought I saw... That is a bugbear. That means that we are fighting one right now. It means that we are close to the exit of the level. Typically what they do is they'll throw in a monster from the next level. Ooh, this is cursed. We do not want that. That's actually better than Detect Magic, because normally Detect Magic doesn't reveal cursed items. That's actually really damn cool. Let's see, how are we doing? Alright, no spells. I mean, sleep. Just rest to get our spells back here. And we're gonna ID these things, see what we got. Chime of Opening, cool, opens locked doors, and a Ring of Dexterity, which will bump us from a 13 to, I think, like a 17. Or a 14. Boo. Well, our class... I don't think... Yeah, that's not enough to drop our AC any. You start dropping AC, I think, at... It's either 16 or 15. I know that by, like, an 18 Dexterity, your character stands at, like, a normal AC of, like... 6. 5 or 6. And as you can see, the game does have an auto-map feature. You can actually... This is old school. You can print your maps and save them to discs. You can't drop notes, though, which... were it not this game, would kind of suck, but this game really isn't one where you need notes. Alright, we have a parchment. Oh, it's a map of the level. Cool. So we've explored most everything. We'll finish up here and then head down. I'm not going to backtrack all the way down there. And then it crumbles to dust, and we have another wand. And, ooh, a gold coin. We will take gold coins over silver coins any day. However, I'm not going to hoard them. Like, once I've got about 3 of them, I'll just stop picking them up. Because they're nice, but they aren't... You don't need them. No. Okay. Oh, you obnoxious little bastards. Die. Oh, and we've got things coming in behind us, too. We got a nice little swarm up here. Oh! Devon, watch your hit points. Which reminds me, I need to switch that hit point display off of the frickin' bar. I hate the bar displays so much. They tell me nothing. We're gonna do that right now. Actually, we're gonna save, too. Show numbers. There we go. 10 of 14. That is much more helpful than 5/8 of a bar. Okay. Come on. Oh! You little bastard. Getting hit is bad. It makes us use food that I'd rather not use. Yeah. Back in the day, I think you healed hit points equal to, like, half your level every 10 hours. It sucked. Everybody wanted a cleric in the party. God damn it. Wand of Hinder Foe, we don't care about. That's fairly useless, because if you're being careful, you either shouldn't be getting hit, or you kill things before they're able to, really do much to you. What we really need to pick up is like a rod of smiting. They are incredibly powerful. That are one of the artifact weapons. Ow! Of which there are a number. I have a fireball, guys. Have two. Gene is displeased. Alright, let's see, where is it? Well, I'll be. Where was that? Oh, up in the corner there. Yeah, you don't have to click directly on a button to activate it in this. Ow! No, you can just kind of click on the wall, and if there's a button there, it'll activate it, which is kind of cheap, but that's okay. We're going to sleep again, because I'm being derpy. And we are getting close to starvation, so we should probably eat. Good boy, Devon. Don't starve to death. Another magic ring. Hi, guys. And the reason I'm killing more or less everything I come across, because I could just leave and ignore these guys, is I do want to gain levels. I don't remember what, fucking protection from spell. I do not care for the protection from X scrolls. The protection from, petrification is useful. Protection from cold, not so much. I think we're actually gonna leave them here. Because I honestly can't think of anything off the top of my head that deals cold damage in this, outside of running into your own, like, ice storms and stuff. You goblinoid bastards. Alright, what do we got left here? Another one. Okay. We're gonna save here, and we're actually gonna rest too, because this game actually has copy protection on it, and if it isn't cracked in this version, I downloaded this off of Abandonia, because it's abandonware. And if the copy protection isn't cracked, let's see here. Oh yeah, ability scores, let's see here. Pray for spells. Ooh, starts with an E. Easy. Here we go. I don't know if this will actually crash fraps. No, it just drops us here. Alright, I'm gonna pause the video and I will be back in just a second and we will carry on.